Hi, I am Patrick Ogle, and I am here at GearWire talking about acoustic guitars, as usual. Recently, we talked about an Ibanez acoustic guitar, Ibanez, known for their fine acoustic instruments worldwide. And we're talking mainly about guitars right now, a series on guitars that are relatively inexpensive. And this is a Yamaha FG700S. It's a dreadnought, obviously. And when I, not knowing much about some of the guitars we got, I kind of anticipated the Ibanez was not going to be a fantastic guitar. And I anticipated some other guitars were not going to be fantastic guitars. And for the price, I turned out to be wrong, and they were pretty good. This is another one of those. I have always thought Yamaha guitars were crap. And it's not, that's a very, like, uneducated opinion, because I know that there are older Yamahas that are decent. There's some early 70s one that some people swear by. I just, every time I picked one up, I went, yeah. But this one is decent. It is, unlike the Ibanez that we just talked about a little bit ago, said that it had a solid spruce top, and I kind of didn't believe it. I can't swear that it's not a solid spruce top. It doesn't sound like a solid spruce top. It doesn't look like any kind of solid wood. It just made me suspicious. And it doesn't mean that it's not. It could just be the smallest, thinnest, crappiest piece of spruce ever cut made into guitars. Says that it's a solid spruce top, and I do believe it. You can see the grain around the, you're not gonna be able to get it on the camera, but you can see, like, when you look inside the hole, do you see what looks like a laminated wood, like, which means wood that's put together like laminate, or do you see the grain of the wood? And in this case, this is solid wood. NATO back and sides and a spruce top. This guitar lists at $299. Realistically, you can pick it up for about $200, and it is a really good guitar for that money. I've talked about some of the Washburn guitars. The D10S is one I keep bringing up, and there's a D10S cutaway electric and some of those things. And I've spoken highly of those because they cost, like, I don't remember exactly, but it's like $220 or something like that. This is every bit as good as those, and possibly a little bit better. You know, I've said this before too, and I'm going to say it again. So if you can just, like, do something else if you've already seen this. You can tell by when you pick up a guitar and feel it, what it feels like, how substantial it feels. And, you know, I mean, it sounds kind of obvious, but I think people sometimes get mesmerized by what they look like. I think, you know, that happens, unfortunately, all too often. This just looks like an average guitar. It is an average guitar. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying this is the greatest guitar ever cut out of, made on Earth or anything. But for $200, boy, you're gonna have a hell of a time beating it. It's the, right out of the box, the action. Some of the other ones I'm talking about the action's too high on them, and you'd have to have an adjustment made or have somebody. But Jesus, when you pay $200 for a guitar, do you really want to go have $50 worth of work done on it right out of the bat, off the bat? No, you don't. This one came out right out of the box for me. The action is kind of low, but not too low. There's a little bit of buzziness. If you listen to, I was playing a little bit, and you could hear some buzziness on the open strings. So that's probably a result of the action being very low, in part. But it is a pretty good guitar. It also is another one that seemed to have kind of stayed in tune. It had something here, premium anti-rust strings. I don't know what the hell that means, but it's probably some promotion for some strengthening. I don't know. You have to ask the people at Yamaha. What I would say is just have a chamois and wipe your strings off. And for the love of God, don't leave the strings on your guitar so long until they rust. You know, you can tell when they start to feel a little bit funky, it's probably time to take them off. Although some people like that completely dead string feel. So what else can I say about this Yamaha? It's a nice guitar. I'd say a beginner. This would be a great buy for a beginner. And if you don't play the acoustic guitar much, but you're a fairly serious musician. You're like one of these guys who's like, rock. Likewise, I'd say this is probably a decent choice to have as a guitar to sit around and fool with if you just want an acoustic, but you're not really focused on the acoustic. You don't want to dump a bunch of money into it. This is one of the best guitars values I've seen. And I've seen a bunch of guitars and gone to a bunch of places where they had guitars and of varying values. Not spectacular, but for the price, very hard to beat. And this is coming from somebody who was prejudiced against Yamahas, much like I was prejudiced against Washburn. So unfortunately, once again, I'm going to have to say nothing but pretty nice things about this guitar, and I'm hoping we'll get some really we'll get some really crappy guitars in so I can vent some spleen. But this one has a big sound. You can hear the low notes and the high notes and the mid range, and it's just, you can hear the buzz too of those, but you know, that's a small problem. You can fix it. So that's that. The Yamaha FG700S.